You have asked about the future gravitational wave detectors. Let me first mention about what is the gravitational wave. According to the Einstein's general relativity, gravity is described by the distortion of the space-time. For example, in this figure, the space-time is flat when there is no object, and the yellow ball can move straight. While when there is a massive object, the space-time is distorted and the yellow ball is attracted towards the massive object. This attraction force is what we call gravity. And 2 years later, he also predicted that this space-time distortion can propagate as a wave. That is gravitational wave. Maybe it is difficult to imagine when I say the distortion of space-time, but it gives a simple effect that the distance between two bodies changes with time. This animation shows how object moves if a gravitational wave passes through the screen. The vertical distance expands when horizon distance shrinks, and vice versa. This gravitational wave was predicted about 100 years ago, but since the distance change is very tiny, it has been considered very difficult to detect. However, in 2015, the American experiment LIGO finally achieved the first detection of gravitational waves, and it was from a binary black hole. Furthermore, in 2017, LIGO and the European detector Virgo detected gravitational waves from neutron star binary. They also announced the detection of 10 binary black holes events so far. They are now running the third observation with upgraded sensitivities, and in addition, the Japanese gravitational wave detector Kagura will join to the international detector network soon. With multiple detectors, we can increase the sensitivity, resolution, and sky coverage. There are already a lot of event candidates, and it's getting more and more exciting for gravitational wave astronomy. LIGO uses an interferometer to measure the distance change by gravitational waves. This figure gives a very simple idea of how to detect gravitational waves. The experiment has 2 orthogonal laser arms. There is a mirror at the end of each arm to reflect the laser back so that when the distance of the 2 arms changes by gravitational waves, you can see the interferometric pattern changes. One of the factors to increase the sensitivity is to have long arm lengths. In the case of LIGO, it's 4 km. Coming back to the question, yes, gravitational wave detector will be launched to space in 2034. The name of the detector is LISA, and they constitute a laser interferometer with the arm length of 2.5 million kilometers. Thanks to the very long arm lengths, we can observe gravitational waves with a good sensitivity at different wavelengths. The gravitational wave detector can observe gravitational waves whose sensitivity is similar to the arm lengths. So in the case of LISA, it will observe very low frequency gravitational waves, and it's sensitive to more massive black hole binaries. In addition, there is a possibility to probe cosmological gravitational wave background. Gravitational waves may be generated in the early universe, where the universe experienced inflation and phase transitions. Those events could generate gravitational waves, and some interesting models of the early universe can be tested by LISA. So LISA provides a very exciting opportunity for this possibility. I hope I answered your question. どうもありがとうございました。